Good evening, everyone. This is Mary, and tonight I wanted to share with you guys one of my favorite collections of children's books. These are called the Best in Children's Books. They are by Nelson Doubleday, and to the best of my knowledge, they were probably a series of books that were maybe something that your parents would have a subscription to for you, and they would come out yearly, quarterly, something like that. Of the ones that I have, they are copyright anywhere between 1959, 1961, something like that. And the stories within them have different copyright dates, you know, anywhere from the classics like Rip Van Winkle, to other little stories that have copyrights in like the 30s, anything like that. So they're basically kind of like repurposing content for inside of these books. But they're really pretty neat. And you can see on the spine of each book, you have little illustrations that kind of talk about what the book is going to talk about. So, you know, there's a cat story, a fox story. Sometimes you can't really put them together until you've looked through the book and read the stories, and then you kind of see where the little illustration came from. And they're pretty neat. They're all done in the same way, with unique illustrations on each of them. This one you'll see there's a little maybe colonial guy, lobster, a cat, some flowers, an anchor. I'm honestly not sure what that is. Maybe fruit in a basket. I'm not sure what that is either. But the front kind of tells the story of some of the things that are inside. This is an illustration from one of the stories inside this particular one. And this is referring to the little article or story. Some of them are stories, and some of them are historical, some of them are scientific, so it's kind of a blend of all, which is what kind of makes these neat. But they have a little bit about stamp collecting and coins throughout the ages in this one. So, and they each have a table of contents on the back, as well as inside. And these are that you call this little part of the book. Those are end papers. So they're usually have a little design on them, especially the old vintage stuff. And the end papers are the same in the front as the back. You get a better look there. They're really pretty neat. History, science, fairy tales, little boy reading, the Old West, geography. Talks a little bit about all those things, so kind of neat. So this one, the main story here, the kind of longer story, is the Rip Van Winkle. And you have other little stories like Mr. A and P, about two men and a supermarket they have. Shells of the Land and Sea, which is more like a scientific sort of thing with some actual color plates, things like that. They're kind of neat too, because you'll have this inexpensive paper which gives you this sort of rag edge, and then you'll have more expensive paper mixed in like this, that as you can see, it does not have the rag edge. It is a smoother paper for the color plate. But I really enjoy the limited color illustration like this. So I like all of it, but Mr. A&P, I wonder if that's a reference a little bit to the A&P grocery store chains, one of the first grocery store chains. I tried to put that together, but I couldn't tell. I don't think it was a direct reference. I think it was just a little reference back. There's the historical, has little illustrations of the money. And the other things that people used to use as money. So there was, you know, some literature and education, scientific and historical education as well. So I would have enjoyed these a lot. And at the end of each of them, it, promotes learning about another country. This one was Canada, so it talks a little bit about Canada and shows some actual pictures. And then you have this really bright and colorful map. It's pretty neat. You can see the little lobster there in the illustration that you find on the spine. They're pretty neat little books. And you'll see how the end papers are the same. There's George Washington here. You can see it back here. But the colors are different. And the colors of the illustrations, you still have some of these full plate, full color things. But the colors of the illustrations kind of change. Tone as well. I thought it was interesting, like, how you have, like, the Songs of Nature by Alfred Tennyson in here. Kind of like a little bit of poetry. I come from the haunts of Coot and Hern. I make a sudden sally and sparkle out among the fern to bicker down a valley. I don't know about back then, but I'm pretty sure little kids now would have no idea how to interpret that. I'm not sure that I do now. But it's really nice. Mother Goose. And these are always ones that you've heard a lot. This is one that my mom used to say with rings and rings on her fingers and bells on her toes. She used to say this one a lot, and it's calming of a nursery rhyme. So then they have a little story about Edison and Marconi, some scientific stuff and history. That talk about different cultures. And the country that we get to learn about in the back of this book is Germany. So you'll see some names. Rudyard Kipling. Sometimes there's poetry. And some more simple types of things. E is for eye. What do you see with your eye? Do you see this E? E is for egg. E is for eat. And the hen lays an egg for you to eat. So, it was kind of designed for a range of children to enjoy. Maybe you had a little brother or sister and you were a little older, so this book would have something for you and your younger sibling. I really enjoy all the simple little illustrations. And in the back of this book, we are traveling to Italy. So you see there's the flag and the map. Shows Vesuvius, Tower of Pisa, Rome, and some other things that I'm sure that they teach you about in the previous pages. So, this one we have Little Red Riding Hood, Hiawatha, Dr. Raggedy Andy, oh, those are great. To admit, I have not read all of these, and I really want to. These are stories that we kind of all know some reference to, but they feel really deep for a children's book, so I feel like there's still a lot to be gained from reading some of these stories and the poetry and things like that. Interesting, the story of the first men. It would, might be pretty interesting to see the perspective there from 1937. It's kind of interesting. The layers, sort of an archaeological perspective. little possum. Life in the Everglades. What country do we learn about? Let's visit Japan. So we'll learn about Japan. And we have a map. The map talks about different mountains, statue of Buddha, a sumo wrestler, a farmer in a rice paddy. Geisha girl. Kind of neat. And once again, in papers with a different color in the scheme. All your references here. Cute little bunnies. The little Red Riding Hood was really nice. Another Rudyard Kipling, How the Rhinoceros Got His Skin. And you can see a really nice color plate of the story by Abraham Lincoln. Hey, diddle diddle, the cat in the fiddle, the cow jumped over the moon. The little log laughed to see such a sport, and the dish ran away with the spoon. Of course. It's funny here. Mistress Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow? With silver bells and cockle shells and pretty maids all in a row. When I was a kid, we always said Mary, Mary, quite contrary, not Mistress Mary. So I wonder why that changed. Or if I just always said it wrong. Angus and the Cat. Angus was a pretty popular book character by Marjorie Flack. There were several Angus books. He's just sort of a little Scotty dog that had lots of little adventures. Australia. There's the flag, and there's a little map about gold processing plants and kangaroos and koala bears, the dingoes, platypus, kind of neat. So that's kind of interesting too. First prayers and graces. So it's the Now I Lay Me Down to Sleep. Very quick little first prayers. like in this book, we don't learn about our country at the very end, we're learning about it in the middle. So we're visiting Thailand in the middle of the book. And there's a map. So they changed the format just a little bit. Gingham dog and a calico cat. A lot of pink and red. So Alice in Wonderland is the main feature. Three little kittens. And that's a completely different style of illustration. Blink, blink. A little bit more modern, it seems like. The three little kittens. Okay, that's cute. Perfect little bows and eyes. And there's the kind of reinterpretation is on the cover. Very nice. And these are the classic illustrations from Alice in Wonderland. I think these are the ones that are technically out of copyright now. But yes, I really like those. And the country we learn about, and this one is Brazil. Butterflies and toucans and anteaters. Pretty nice. All the different. Talking about Brazil. All the different little icons on the. You can see all of the Aesop's fables that they want to share kind of in the front. This one has a few pages that are loose, unfortunately. Three Little Bears. teddy bear. Oh, that's kind of neat. Little songbook. The farmer in the dell, the farmer in the dell, hi, oh, the merrier, the farmer in the dell. The dog takes the cat takes the rat. Gosh, I haven't thought about that in a long time. Cheese stands alone. London Bridge. The mulberry bush. It kind of also gives you like the main chorus, but then kind of tells you how to sing the rest. Like, this is the way you do all of these different things. Here we go, Loopy-Loo. I don't really remember this one. I vaguely remember, but it wasn't one that I knew. That's pretty neat. I feel like those are things that kids now don't know the mulberry bush song and all those kinds of things. I don't know if they teach them those things anymore. And the country we learn about is Holland. There's our map. Windmills, cows, daffodils, canals, little milkmaids in wooden shoes. Some Adventures of a Brownie. I don't know what this is. It's a little brownie. Looks like a little elf. History talks about Robert E. Lee. I always like these two poems. Wintertime. The bells, the first snowfall. And I wonder if any of the timing winter theme, if it coincided with maybe when the book came out. Oh, well, we have spring. There's spring. Little lamb, here I am. Come and lick my white neck. Let me pull your soft wool. Let me kiss your soft face. Merrily, merrily, we welcome in the year. William Blake. And a little bit about dinosaurs. Allosaurus, Stegosaurus, Tyrannosaurus. I feel like he looks different. So maybe this is the 1950s definition of a Tyrannosaurus. He looks more like a lizard with little short arms. His face was a little bit more like a regular lizard. A little bit different the way these are drawn than what we see now. And I think this little story about the dog named Taffy was also a regular book, kind of like the little Scotty dog. But I think there are a series of this particular little dog story. And we're visiting Scotland, this book. Castles and bagpipes. Shipyards, sheep, kind of neat. So this is interesting. I think everyone remembers Babar. So I didn't realize that 1934. Babar was a fairly old story. Those folk knew when I was little. But you see Babar, the elephant that we all kind of know and love. And they have a whole story about Babar. Winking, blinking, and nod. About animals. I think this is about Daniel Boone. Little kitty cats, and those were always kind of my favorites. William Shakespeare's birthplace, Canterbury Cathedral, Stonehenge. Rapunzel, some poetry. Those are nice. That little face is nice. Oh. A little bit about caves. Learning about caves. Stalagmites and stalactites. Little bunny rabbit story. teaching you about tools and what different tools do. And country. Bermuda. Robin Hood. One of the Heidi stories, talking about, it's like raptors of some sort, hunters from the sky. So, kind of a whole thing about birds of prey. And some riddles. This is the first time I've come across riddles. And we're visiting Argentina. Piper, the Ugly Duckling. And let's see, Mexico. And here's the map. Shows Corpus Christi, Chihuahua, Juarez, Veracruz, the Longhorn Steer. There's like fish in the water. Meat. And I think this is the last one that we haven't looked at in a while. Snow White and Rose Red. Our national parks. Some more songs. A dangerous day for Mrs. Doodlepunk. Those are nice. The mouse with bobbed whiskers. virtually dotting the map of Europe are five interesting countries that are so little that put all together they amount to barely more than the size of Long Island, New York. So what they've done is kind of pinpoint them. And pull them out. So they're talking about Monaco, Andorra, San Marino, Liechtenstein, in Luxembourg. Yeah. So, that's kind of an interesting way to do that. Well, that about wraps it up for this set of books. I really hope that you enjoyed sort of looking at all the different things that they've included. Maybe it brought back some good memories for you. Just give me a shout if there's something in there that you remember that, from this video that kind of brought back memories. It kind of brings back memories for me, so I really enjoy looking at all this stuff, and I hope you did too. Thanks.